SB Foot Tanning Company was first established along the banks of Trout Brook near Red Wing, founded in 1872 by Silas B. Foot and George Sterling. The SB Foot Tanning Company has been a part of the Red Wing community for generations. It moved operations into its current location on Bench Street in 1908. Silas Buck Foot, SB, was a farmer, inventor, and shoemaker who left Pennsylvania in 1853, settling in Red Wing in 1857. Owner of a hand pump patent and a former general store owner, Silas operated several mercantile stores in Red Wing before a turn of events landed a large quantity of shoes at his feet. He immediately recognized the needs for better quality shoes for local farmers and businessmen alike. In 1897, Foot became the sole owner of the tannery, incorporating the business as Silas B. Foot & Company. The focus of the tanning business became a family tradition. His son, Edwin Holly Foot, E.H., joined the father at the tannery and was instrumental in its continued success. E.H. Foot began overseeing the company's daily operations in 1898. When the factory became a liability and was needed to be rebuilt to remain competitive, he convinced Silas to reinvest in a new factory in 1908. E.S. became the president and owner of the business the same year when Silas passed away. In 1957, 100 years after Silas had first arrived in Minnesota in search of a better way of life, his son, E.H. Foot, passed away and was succeeded by his son, Silas B. Foot II, who presided over business until 1972. Then the business was passed to E.H. Jr., S.B. Foot II's brother, who in turn passed leadership of the business to Silas B. Foot III. In 1986, Red Wing Shoes, itself a privately owned company with over a century of family tradition and adherence to the principles of quality and functionality, acquired SB Foot Tanning Company. The tannery remains in operations using updated techniques originally developed by Silas and E.H. Foot. Many tannery employees have years of history with the tannery, some with family connections that stretch back generations. SB Foot Tanning Company was and remains a family affair. Red Wing Shoe traces its history to 1905 when German immigrant Charles Beckman closed his retail shoe store and organized the Red Wing Shoe Company with 14 other investors. The young company initially manufactured 110 pairs of shoes per 10-hour day. The brand's steady growth stemmed from booming industries of farming, logging, mining, blacksmithing, and railroading that represented largely untapped footwear markets. Red Wing tailored its shoes to the demands of specific customer groups, offering a wide range of shoe sizes and widths to ensure fit and a constantly growing line of specialized products with different capabilities. The development of rubber added significantly to Red Wing's success in early decades. In the early 1930s, president of the company, J.R. Sweezy, introduced the rubber cord sole to replace the leather norm. His gamble with the new material proved both lucrative and trend-setting. The grow cord soles and Goodyear heels used in Red Wing shoes set the standard for a shoe industry that grew to depend almost exclusively on synthetic materials. The company's brands included Red Wing, Irish Setter, Basque, and Works. The Sweezy family of Red Wing solely owned Red Wing Shoe. Until the 1970s, Red Wing's reputation rested primarily on a wide variety of footwear marketed as work shoes, emphasizing their practical applications in the workplace. By the mid-1980s, however, as U.S. workers moved increasingly out of industrial and agricultural sectors into service-related jobs, the company's scope changed. Under the direction of a new president, William J. Sweezy, and a new generation of management, the company's emphasis shifted from work shoes to shoes for work, a slight semantic change that underscored the company's new commitment to innovative lines of lighter, more comfortable footwear developed to accommodate new work-oriented recreational needs. By the end of the 1990s, Red Wing sold more than 3 million pairs of shoes and boots per year through a worldwide network of more than 4,200 dealers. Within the U.S. market, a network included about 400 Red Wing shoe stores, of which about 160 were company-owned. About 15% of overall revenues were generated from sales outside the United States in more than 100 countries worldwide. Rydell Shoes Incorporated was founded in Red Wing over 65 years ago in 1945 by Paul Rydell and his wife Sophie. With the blessing of his former employer, Red Wing Shoe Company, Paul embarked on developing comfortable, quality skating boots when the legend of Rydell began. Paul, a member of both the Ice and Roller Skating Hall of Fame, is credited with making recreational skating widely available to children, teens, and adults through the creation of comfortable, affordable skates. Today, Paul's grandsons, Bob, Dan, Scott, and Paul Riggleman, along with 95 skilled employees, manufacture the most complete line of figure skates available in the world. Rydell also manufactures roller skates. Rydell skates are distributed internationally. From the beginning, Rydell knew fit was essential for both skating enjoyment and top performance. In the early days, Paul Rydell borrowed a friend's medical books to study the structure and movement of feet. Combined with his knowledge of skating and shoemaking, he developed skating shoe design that accommodates a skater's motions on the ice. The manufacturing process for building figure skates is labor-intensive and involves as many as 125 different production steps. To ensure a proper fitting skate, the factory-authorized dealers use a special fitting scale. This allows the customer to buy the exact fitting skate, one that has more than 120 production steps. Rydell products have long been the choice of champions. Four-time world champion Kurt Browning is a believer, wearing the top-of-the-line Rydell skates. Three-time U.S. champion Johnny Weir wears Rydell's custom-made skates, as do Olympic champion Jamie Sale, Canadian champion Olympic silver medalist Joanne Rochette. When you seek passion, precision, and perfection on the ice, you need products that perform. Nowhere else in the world can you find the quality, innovation, and selection that skaters need to perform their best than through a Rydell skate. Following the Benedictine Health System's extensive naming process, Benedictine Living Center Red Wing convened a multidisciplinary committee consisting of Chris Bolt, Marianne Sear, Lee Finholm, Joan Foote, Jake Gearing, Pam Horlitz, Sister Mary Krista Croning, OSB, Chaplain Dar Reek, Tony Smith, Becky Urbanski, to develop a list of prospective new names for the facility. Options with reasoning for its selection were submitted to the BHS Mission Committee for approval. Out of those submitted, the Mission Committee has approved the St. Crispin's Living Community as a new name for the future facility on the Mayo Campus. St. Crispin and his brother, St. Crispinian, were martyrs in the early church. They were born to a noble Roman family. Fleeing persecution for their faith to another location and an imitation of St. Paul, they preached Christianity to the Gauls by day and worked with their hands making shoes by night. They earned enough from their trade to support themselves and also to aid the poor. St. Crispin is the patron of shoemakers, saddlers, and tanners. That name was chosen because of the role shoemaking and leather tanning has played in the rich history of Red Wing, Red Wing Shoe, SB Foot Tannery, and Rydell, and has continued to be a positive force in the economy of Red Wing and its citizens for many years. St. Crispin gave what he didn't need for his own well-being to the poor. He lived the core values by extending a welcoming hand to those who wanted to hear God's words, by sharing what he had with those less fortunate, by respecting the needs of others, and by justly opposing temptations for which his persecutors deemed a better life. St. Crispin's life and example aligns perfectly with what we as BHS try to live every day, namely to witness to God's love by providing compassionate, quality care with special concern for the underserved and those in need.